What it do, homies? It's your boy Dave, and I'm back today. We out here with another BTS reaction. This time we checking out their song Mike Drop, and it's got Steve Aoki on there. You know he the god out here when it comes to producing. Did you guys know that Steve Aoki's dad is like super famous and everything, like super famous and rich? I forgot what it was that he does, but somebody was telling me that the other day, and then I was like, yo, that's pretty cool. You know, I always find it as a little difficult for people who are come from like rich parents to kind of find their own identity, you know what I mean, without living in their parents' shadow. Steve Aoki did just that, so I definitely respect him for that. But let's go ahead and shut up and turn it up. You know, BTS always got some amazing like movie quality design and stuff. I got CC on, so we ready. Okay. Okay, hold on. So this the ultimate flex song, bro. That's what they doing. Mic Drop. The prelude is like they pretty much telling you some of the feedback that they got, right? And then how they dishing it back out saying, oh yeah, you doing this? Well, I'm doing this. And it tops whatever you was doing times 10. Mic Drop, lead the stage. Okay. One bar that stood out to me right here was, and of course, let me see where we're at. We're at 229. So right here. So, hold on. It's kind of hard to find where I need to go because I need subtitles. But he said something about, he said my spoon's filthy, right? I come from a crap. Okay, so that might be the translation. I didn't need that. I knew what that meant. He said, I don't care when I grab a mic, I beat those who got golden spoons. So he's basically saying that even though he came from a lesser place than somebody else, the people who were born with everything, right, they still getting beat. And that just speaks to your talent. You know what I mean? So no matter how good you are, if you can't deliver, if you can't perform, you're going to get beat by somebody. And one thing that's true when you remain at the top, you know, for so long, is that you lose your hunger. So you could very easily get beat out by people who are at the low because they got so much more to fight for. So let me see if we go chewing over and over at the Stars Dinner, World Business Core. I think what we're going to do is we're going to go check the lyrics after this so I can kind of enjoy the video. And then, you know, without pausing so much. One thing that I also liked about this was at 223, right? Okay. One thing that I liked about this as well is when he said, we got the bag, you see how they're moving with their choreography? For some reason, that just kind of gave me two different ideas. The first idea it gave me is what it's like hustling, you know, always moving, always going. But also when you think about a bag and how when you're walking, it's just going back and forth because it's bouncing, because, you know, it's bouncing based off you. It kind of gave me the idea of a bag that's bouncing. So that's pretty cool, man. I know that BTS puts a lot of thought and concept in their dancing, and that's one of the things that I like of them as a group. So okay, hold on, is that Suga? Oh man, hold on now. Hey, check this out. So I just, you know, I kind of had a little bit of an idea as to what the kind of concept was. I mean, I understand what the concept, but that's interesting. When they show this right here, this kind of gives you that idea of like a press release, right? When all of them sit down, and then think of Steve Aoki as kind of like the paparazzi that's answering the questions. Now, one thing about the paparazzi is that they make a whole lot of noise, right? It's just a bunch of chitter chatter. So think of Steve Aoki as the audience that's making a whole lot of noise with this track and everything. And also, if we pay attention, this kind of looks like the inside of a prison, not prison, but like, you know, when detectives sit you down and ask you questions and stuff, trying to investigate you. That's what this kind of looks like. And it also looked like Steve Aoki was staring at him through, you know, one of those one way looking glasses, as if they're being dissected and everything. So we think about that, and that kind of brings everything all together when people are criticizing him, asking him all these questions and everything. Oh, you, like you say, you was born with a dirty spoon and everything. How you dealing with this success and everything? This is like I feel like this is a song that's like a clap back to all the haters and everything. And here's one thing, man. And of course, the army, you absolutely love to see something like this. You know what I mean? Because how many times they've had to defend their status to the world? You know what I'm saying? They probably get so much hate, and it's uncalled for, because they're obviously a very, very talented group. How come people can't just be super happy about their talent? Right. So absolutely amazing. There's not really too much to dissect here. I pretty much understood most of it, but I do want to look at the first part of the lyrics, because he has some Ratatouille in there. So something like that. And I want to check out the lyrics here real quick. And I'm not going to go to that one website that I usually go to, because I don't think there's a lot of translation that needs to be done here. Okay. Bro, That says Japanese version. Interesting. Okay, here we go. Steve, we need to look at the remix. I just realized that this was a remix, so I didn't see the actual one. Also, was that Suga who did the second one? Was it somebody else? Okay, anyways, let me take a look at these lyrics. Let's see. See my bag, see my that's the chorus right there. Okay, so that's Jim and Jen, Mike Bundy. I'm trying to look for it. It seemed like they were saying a whole lot more, but this is a translation. Oh, I guess I do have to go to the other website to get the actual lyrics, because I'm getting them in a different language. Yep, here it goes. Okay. Yeah, I just wanted to see the stuff about the Ratatouille, but I mean, it's fine. You know, for the most part, I understood what this was about. I absolutely love it. The beat's just stupid crazy. We even got a car explosion, bro. That's how you know a video is lit, when there's car explosions. And you got to remember, when you badass, you don't look at car explosions. They always happen in the back of you. But it was just, it was random, and it kind of adds to that hype and that energy and everything. That's when, if you weren't already popping off, right? Like they said, they were popping off. If you weren't already popping off, then that was the time to do so. Just freaking go crazy, go nuts. All right, y'all. Y'all let me know what y'all thought about this down in the comments. That's the end of this video. If you enjoyed the content, leave a like and subscribe. Dave's out.